I'm Dr. Ganapathy. I'm medical director of Mangala Hospital and Kidney Foundation. I'm also senior consultant anesthesiologist and critical care medicine specialist. This is a typical oxygen bubble hood which we've been using on COVID patients, and I would like to explain how this has to be used effectively. So this is the hood. This is the transparent hood over it. This is a rubber sheet which fits onto the neck of the patient. These are the two rings which hold them, and these are two ports, one for inlet and one for exhaust. Once the hood is opened, we fix one catheter pump to one of the ports. We fix one catheter mount to one of the ports, and then we fix a viral filter to the other end, and then we use a mechanical peep valve and fix it. If you see, this mechanical peep valve has settings to give peep from 5 cm up to 20 cm. This peep has to be adjusted to the comfort of the patient. If the patient feels there is too much of pressure in the hood, we have to release it. If patient feels there isn't enough pressure, we can tighten and give more peep to the patient. So that takes care of the expired gas. Then you can use any ventilator, either a single hood single pipe ventilator, single connected ventilator, or a double hose ventilator connected to HME filter and one more catheter mount, and it is fixed to the hood. It is fixed to the hood. Then now it is ready for insertion. We stretch this. Before that, we have to put the ear plug to the patient because there will be positive pressure inside the hood so that patient doesn't feel the pressure. Then we stretch this rubber and it is left to patient's shoulder. Then there are two straps which can be fixed to the patient like this. Okay, now it is ready. Now, in the machine, we go for PSP and IV. We can go for regular mode also. Non-invasive is preferred. We can use straight away PSP also. PSP and IV, and then switch on the machine. And I've kept a pressure support of 15 peep of 5 and respirator at 12. In the machine, if you have option to go to the machine settings and switch off the expiratory spirometer, please do it so that the frequent alarms in case of minimal leak is avoided. So if you see now, I have muted the expiratory spirometer and I can also activate it. If you have option to mute it, please mute it. Then this is the page to monitor. Okay. Now if you see, the hood fixes onto the patient tightly and it bubbles up nicely. And this is the inlet, this is the exhaust. I've kept this very minimal to adjust to his comfort, the mechanical peep valve here. I can tighten it to increase and give extra peep in case the patient's saturation doesn't improve and if the patient doesn't feel adequate oxygen is being delivered. This is transparent and patients do not feel claustrophobic with it. So this, here again I'm showing the mechanical peep valve and how to adjust it. This virus filter that we touch here takes care of the virus that is coming out from the patient during the process of expiration so that the contamination and viral load in the ICU is reduced drastically so the staffs are not exposed to high viral load. In this, I'm going to explain how we can use an ordinary snorkeling mask. This is a snorkeling mask provided by the Decathlon company. And it comes with a fitting here. You can easily remove that fitting. And what I've made is I've made two types of connectors to the snorkeling mask. One is a single port connector, and other one is, if you see here, is a double port connector. Both have their own uses. Now I will explain how to use a single port connector. You take the connector, attach it here. There is a rubber washer that we provide. This can be fixed here in case there are any signs of leak. The rubber washer is slipped onto it. And then the connector goes in tightly. Now if you see the connector gets attached firmly, and then all that we have to do is connect the single port here to a filter and a catheter port. If you see, this is ventilator outlet. This is a double hose ventilator that I'm using here. With this double hose ventilator, we have to use a single port connector to use it, use this knocking mask as a mask for NIP. So, ventilator is connected through a HME filter, it is connected to the connector here. This single port connector is only for using with ventilators which have an inlet and outlet separately. That is two hose ventilators. Once it is fixed, it is inserted onto the patient. It fits very snugly and tightly on the patient, and I have switched on the machine and it is delivering adequate oxygenation to the patient. This mask is nothing different from an ordinary mask that we use for giving NIV, non-invasive ventilation. If you see, this is one mask that we have available. This is one more mask that we have available. But what I have seen is, when we use these kind of masks for long duration on COVID patients, because of the pressure generated, they develop pressure sores along the lines on which these masks are fitting, because these masks are fairly rigid. The edges are not very smooth and not very comfortable to the patient. So with this mask, we can achieve a better fit, less leak, and also more comfort to the patient. Stop. Now I'm explaining how to use the same snorkeling mask with the single port, double port connector, and use it with ventilators which have single hose, or use with a high flow oxygen device, or use with the BiPAP CPAP machine. So the only change that we have to make is, instead of the single port connector, we have to fix the double port connector like this. And if you see, there are two ports here. One is inlet, one is exhaust, one is outlet. The outlet is connected to a catheter mount, again connected to a viral filter, and connected to a mechanical peep valve for you to adjust the peep value to patient's comfort level. And other port is connected, if you see here, to a high flow oxygen device. If you see, this is an ordinary BiPAP CPAP machine, and we can attach the connector and the catheter mount, and it is fixed to the snorkeling mask. And this is an ordinary BiPAP CPAP machine. If you see here, that's a Philips Respironics, and this is how the patient gets oxygenated using two ports. So if you have a single, imagine if this is a single port, a single hose ventilator, this is how it has to be connected. We need to have a two port connector, a mechanical peep valve, two catheter mounts. And in case you have to connect it to high flow oxygen device, all that you have to do is take the high flow oxygen device connector, remove the nasal cannula, fix it with the catheter mount, fix it onto the catheter mount. With the catheter mount, fix it onto the snorkeling mask, and with this, patient will get high flow oxygen as per your settings. Again, the only advantage, the advantages with the snorkeling mask is, it is better fit, patients are more comfortable, and the incidence of pressure sore that we see with ordinary mask, which we use routinely for NIV, is reduced using a snorkeling mask. These masks are available in India in plenty. This one I've chosen from Decathlon. Thank you.